and welcome to the session. I'm Igal Figlin, Partner PM Manager, and I oversee Azure Core Fundamentals. During the next few minutes, I'd like to share some exciting news. We will present, in conjunction with Citrix engineering and product management representatives, the capabilities that Citrix Provisioning Services, PVS, is now making available on Azure. First, I would like to give you some context and discuss important aspects of our collaboration with the Citrix team. You will be able to see how Citrix PVS works on Azure and the new capabilities now available to you. Lastly, I will share some additional resources for you to learn more about the offering. Over the past 2 years, many organizations have shifted to VDI solutions in the cloud, which offer more resilience, agility, and scalability to meet unexpected shifts in workforce needs. The trend to move to cloud continues as we adjust to new hybrid work models. Microsoft Azure is a preferred cloud for Citrix, and together, Citrix and Microsoft have been building flexibility for customers to transition from their data centers on-prem into Azure and anywhere in between. We have seen customers all over the world take advantage of the value Citrix with Azure Virtual Desktop to drive powerful transformations within their organizations. If you are on-prem Citrix customer today, you're likely familiar with Citrix PVS, a core Citrix image management technology, and its powerful advantage to OS delivery to your hypervisors. In addition to our flexible migration plan for your Citrix cloud services and VDA workloads, Citrix now offers a new product called Citrix Image Portability to replicate on-prem PVS images into Azure-based PVS deployment. This allows you to move at your own pace through the migration journey. If you are ready to go full cloud, you can simply deploy Citrix PVS into your Azure tenant and manage your workloads just like when they were in your own data centers. You will enjoy the familiar management interface and high-performance delivery you have been accustomed to for years. Citrix and Microsoft engineers have been hard at work to enhance the scalability and performance of our offerings. We are excited to bring PVS exclusively to Azure. Together, we tackled some of the biggest challenges facing large-scale cloud deployments, resulting in high performance and simplified manageability, all on Azure. As organizations worldwide are looking to the cloud for new ways to support hybrid work, they can count on us. We have implemented a set of performance improvements allowing to blazingly fast provision, start, and manage VMs at scale, both Linux and Windows. The Citrix team, who will discuss their solution in a moment, were able to start hundreds of Windows VMs in around 20 seconds on average, delivering best-in-class results. When IT organizations need to quickly provision their virtual desktops or working environments, without spending money on running the VMs in advance, they can count on Azure fast provisioning capabilities and proven elasticity. Smart Azure mechanisms allow us to understand the customer behavior and optimize the code passes, as well as predicting customer behavior to minimize the stress on the system and ensure blazing fast growth or contraction of the service. Let me pass the mic to you, Holu, to share more details on how Citrix is using the Azure provisioning system.
Thank you, Igor. My name is Yuha Lu. I'm the Director of Product Management at Citrix. It has been great working with Microsoft and your team, and exciting to bring Citrix provisioning to Microsoft Azure. Citrix provisioning, also known as PVS, is a network-based provisioning method, which is a unique technology compared to traditional storage-based provisioning. Instead of cloning and replicating this image, PVS streams the OS image over the network at boot time. PVS is widely adopted by on-prem Citrix customers for its speed and flexibility. It enables our industry-leading image lifecycle management practice, including versionings, canary tests, and instant reset and rollback. And because it is a network-based streaming protocol, it only passes bits that are needed for VM to boot and to operate. This translates to faster machine creation, faster boot time, and reduced storage costs. PVS is a trusted image management solution at scale. And by leveraging the state-of-the-art network backbone in Azure, we can provision thousands of VMs in minutes and boot them in seconds. Here is an example of Citrix provisioning at work. In this example, we're currently running production image version 4. We now create version 5 and power up a maintenance VM. And we make changes with some software and OS patches. When we are satisfied with the image performs the way we want, we can promote this VM from test to production. Now, version 5 is the production image assigned to all of our target VMs. We schedule reboot, and as the target VM come up online, they stream the updated version 5 image. And in case if there is any issue in the production, we can quickly roll back to version 4, our known good image. With a click of a button, all target VMs reboot and roll back to version 4. Now, let me hand over to our architect, Simon Graham, to give you a real-world demo of Citrix provisioning on Azure. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Simon Graham. I'm the architect for provisioning at Citrix, and today I'm going to show you a couple of demos of running Citrix provisioning services on Azure. In this first one, we're going to see how quickly VMs can be provisioned using PVS. And in the screen here, you can see on the right-hand side, the provisioning console. On the left-hand side, the Azure portal, where we'll see the resources appearing. And at the bottom there is a stopwatch, just so you can see the timing that goes on as we create these VMs and how quickly it manages to create the 500 VMs. Okay, so here we go. The first thing we do is select the wizard to create some VMs. And we have to connect to Citrix Virtual Apps and Desktops, and also select the Azure region and provide Azure authentication information. Having done that, we choose a VM to be a template for all of the created VMs. And creating a CVAD catalog, and then here we are saying we're going to create 500 VMs. Pick a resource group to put the VMs in. Create some AD accounts for those VMs we're provisioning. And then we have to specify the PVS servers that are going to act as servers for it. And now we're ready to go. And you see, we finished there at about 2 minutes and 40 seconds. So that's when the provisioning actually started. First thing we do is create a boot disk for these VMs and upload it to Azure. This boot disk is very small, it's 20 megabytes. And now here we are starting to create the VMs. And I'm going to speed things up here because it takes, you know, a few minutes. See the progress going along there. And now you can see resources are appearing in the Azure portal on the left-hand side. And eventually there'll be 2001 resources. That is four for each VM, a virtual machine, a network interface, and two disks, and then the boot image at the top there. Now, all the VMs have been created. We do have a little bit of cleanup to do at the end. Then you will see at about 20 minutes and 20 seconds, the whole thing is complete, which translates to around 2 seconds, just over 2 seconds per VM. Now, if we look in the PVS console, we can see that we now know about all of these 500 devices. They all exist there. And of course, you can see them in the right-hand side there. There we are. We've created them. Okay, in this second demo, we're going to show how easy it is to switch the image that a given virtual machine is running. Again, on the right-hand side here, we have the PVS console. And on the left-hand side, we can see the Azure portal showing the running machines. Okay, we can see all the VMs running Windows 10 here in the PVS console, running a Windows 10 disk. Any one of those is interesting. If we pick maybe 8002, and we can go over here and look on the portal and see again the VMs running. If we pick one of these and connect to it, we see we're actually running Windows 10 Pro in this VM. What we're going to do now is we're going to switch it to Windows Server 2019. So we can go look at the images we have. And we can see here, we have six or seven images. We have the Windows 10 that's in use, and we have the Server 2019. And I can update individual targets, or I can update all of those VMs in one go just by dragging and dropping the new VDisk over the top. And now next time that target boots, it'll actually be running Server 2019. We can actually control that from here on an individual target basis too. So I can go to the target we were looking at. I can tell you I want to restart it. And we'll see very shortly that the VM is actually rebooting. Now, if we go back to the portal here and look at the VM, the serial console on that VM, we will see that it's running right now, and very shortly it will show that it is shutting down, finishing the shutdown, as you can see there. And then in a few seconds, we'll see it starting to boot again. And it's contacting the provisioning server again, and we can see here that it's actually going to be running the Server 2019 image. It's actually starting to boot Windows now. Very shortly, the SAC console will be available, showing it's running. There we are. Now we can go back and reconnect our RDP session through the Bastion. And we're logging on, sped up slightly. And now we can see here that it's actually running Server 2019. We did that without having to reprovision the VM, without having to copy any boot disks or anything like that, just updating the PVS console and rebooting. So those two demos show you the power and performance of Citrix Provisioning Server on Azure and the simplicity of management that our customers love. Back to you, Igal.
Thank you for your time and for watching the demo. Let me leave you with additional information for you to learn more about the offering. Feel free to post comments or contact us directly with any questions. Thank you.